Aloha and good evening. January 8th, 2021. And I'm flying solo tonight. Kaimi is with a friend who she hasn't seen in a while. So I'm looking forward to seeing what happens by myself. I wanted to take a moment to talk about intention, because these instruments move a lot of energy, and that's awesome, and it can do things if you don't have intention set that you may or may not want. And more importantly, the energy that's moved becomes available to you to utilize. Energies can get moved out that need to be grounded out. But also, some of that energy just becomes available for your direction. And so going into events like this with an intention for what you wish to see happen with that energy, I believe, can make it a more powerful experience. So we've talked about intentions before. And I don't have a global intention to set out in this, but I do invite you to take a moment and feel into what you need or want and utilize the energy that's about to be available in supporting those desires or needs. It's not something you have to do. I believe there's benefit in the metal moving and the vibrations that come through. But having intentions, I think, can augment it and increase the potency of what's going on. I'm going to play bowls a little bit, gongs a little bit, rav a little bit, maybe the free notes. I don't really know. I don't have an overall plan. I've moved cameras a little bit. We'll see how that works. I'm gonna go about an hour, a little bit longer, and then there'll be a period of silence before I speak you back in to your body. Feel free to have a little bit of water by you. Get comfortable in a position where you don't have to move for the next hour or so. And we will see you on the other side. Thank you so much for letting this be a part of your life, whenever it is that you're experiencing it. Speakers are good. Headphones are good. I like speakers because it allows the sound to travel through your body. You're 70% water and vibrations. If you've ever tapped a glass full of water, you can see the effect that it has. So, speakers are good. Good speakers. All right. Enjoy your ride, and I'll see you on the other side. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
As we end this gong journey session, the invitation is to find your breath. To notice it where it is, and to follow it home. Maybe allowing for a few slow but deeper breaths than you've been taking. To take notice of sensations in your body. Maybe in your extremities, fingers and toes, tip of your nose, nobody knows where your attention goes, except you. I rarely come into this with a plan of what to share when we're finished, and I just kind of open myself up and attempt to be a hollow bone and let what comes through come through. And hope that it has impact for someone somewhere. This week, I've been struggling yet again with my Virgo persnicketiness, with my knowing there's this guy inside of me who knows that there's a right way to do things. And he's very critical. So I brought him to the men's group that I do work with. And we did a process that was led by a very skilled man, a good friend of mine, where we broke that critic off and had a let him have his say, really feel where he is in my body and what he does and why he's there. Maybe not so much why he's there, but that he's there and strong. And I've been working with that energy for a little while, and it's prompted a change in my mission statement, which is part of what I do with men's work. You know, I don't know that if I'll get it correct, but the mission statement I'm working on currently is to co-create a safe and healthy world by responding from a compassionate heart space. And in the work last night, I found that I have a lot of anger towards that critic. And so we dropped into the other side of it, which is me coming from compassionate heart space and knowing that everyone is doing the best they can. Everyone is doing the best they can with the resources they have. And as we opened up that part of me that has compassionate heart space and invited his attention turn to my critic, there was a shift, and tears that for maybe the first time ever, my critical self was getting loving compassion. With an acknowledgement that he is there for a reason, and while I'd prefer he not run the show, it's okay that he's there. He's a part of me because I've done the best I can with the resources I have available. And I'm acquiring more resources and spending intention and attention on the barometer that is my body that tells me when my critic steps up and starts to get uptight because things aren't going quite the way he thinks is the right way. I don't know why that's there, except it's powerful for me in the moment, but I would like you to know that I firmly believe you are doing the best you can with the resources and skill set you have available. And if that's not working for you, with ease and grace and joy, I invite you to research skill sets and a compassionate heart. Thank you for joining. Whenever you see this, I do enjoy the production. And I hope you do as well. If you do, and you're seeing this on YouTube, subscribe, like. On YouTube, there's going to be a little flag at the beginning showing you a connection to some other videos we've done, or Song of the Gong when Dave was around. Feel free to explore those. And be gentle, be kind. Breathe into that compassionate heart space for yourself first, and then it'll naturally flow to others if that's of interest to you. Thanks and good night.